Hi, my name's Gage, and I'm one of the founders of StreamYard. Until now, collaboration has been a bit difficult in StreamYard, and that's why I'm so excited to announce StreamYard Teams. Let's jump into it. StreamYard Teams lets you invite team members to your account. To invite members, let's go to the Members tab on the left. As you can see on the banner above, we're celebrating the launch of Teams, and for a limited time, you can invite one team member to your account free of charge on any plan. If you're on a paid plan of StreamYard, we're also offering the Teams add-on at a significantly reduced rate. You can find the details if you click that claim discount button. But for right now, let's just jump through the process of inviting a single team member. So I'll go ahead and click the invite team member button. First, I'll need to create and name my team. For this example, I'll just go ahead and name my team Gage's team and click next. To invite a team member, I just need to enter their email address. For this example, I'm going to go ahead and invite Dana. So let me just enter her email right here. I'll also need to go ahead and assign Dana a role. You can learn all about roles by clicking the link below, which goes to our support guide. But just to give you a quick summary, the admin role essentially allows Dana to do everything that I can do as the account owner. She'll be able to change destinations, create broadcasts, go live. Most of my abilities she'll have as well. There's also the co-host option, which limits Dana's abilities to most actions inside of the studio. This could be things like showing comments or banners, things like that. For this example, let's go ahead and select the co-host role. Now I'll go ahead and send the invite, and Dana should receive an email.
Hey, it's Dana. Let's walk through accepting the team invite. Once you've been added to a team, you'll receive an email invitation. Open the email and click accept.
I'll have to log in to join this team. Awesome, now I'm part of his team.
Since I'm added as a co-host, I don't have the create a broadcast button. This is because I can only assist in the broadcast studio. So once Gage creates a broadcast studio, I'll be able to enter the studio and show comments, banners, add shared screens, things like that. I can leave the team at any time by clicking team settings and leave team. I can also switch back to my team by clicking the team toggle in the top left and then clicking back to my own team.
Now I can see that Dana has accepted my invite. I can change her role at any time to admin or back to co-host. I can also remove her from the team if she's no longer a team member and needs to be removed. Next, let's go ahead and create a broadcast so we can see what it's like to work with a co-host during a live broadcast. So I'll go ahead and create a broadcast. I'll just do a record only and call it test. I'll just go ahead and enter the studio. And let's invite Dana so that we can see what her view looks like and the types of actions she can take inside of the studio.
I'm now entering the studio as a co-host. I can test my camera and my mic. I click enter. As a co-host, you'll see I don't have the go live button, but I can do things like show comments, show banners, and change the layout.
As the host, I can actually start the recording. So I'll go ahead and do that now. This is just a test, so I'll only record for a few seconds here and then go ahead and end the broadcast. Again, as the host, I'm the only one that's able to end the broadcast. So I'll end that, and then we'll both take a look at what our personal views look like of the past broadcast. In the dashboard, both Dana and I can view our past broadcasts, but only I will have the option to actually delete or download the recording. If Dana was an admin, she would also have the ability to do those things as well. If I ever need to add more members to my team, I can go ahead and go back to the members section and simply click add more. Here you can see there's an option to add 5 seats to the account at $9 a month. Again, like we mentioned before, this is a limited time offer as a special thank you and to celebrate the launch of Teams. We hope all of you are excited for this feature. We're really excited to see how you use it. Thanks so much.